Hello, hello, hello. So today we are going to draw something different and new style. For that, I'm going to blend Mr. Harry Potter with the clownfish or Nemo. Please watch the whole video because I'm going to show you some tricks. First thing, I'm going to draw a slanted line approximately 1.5 centimeter, and then I'm using this water bottle cap for the glasses. If you don't have, you can use anything or you can just draw the circle. Now you can see I'm showing you two markers. You can pick any of them, but I picked the bigger one and I'm rubbing the pencil on the edge of the cap to make the eye for the Harry Potter. But you can pick any of them or you can just draw. So I got that mark, right? So I can just outline this one and then I will be done. Now it's time to draw the hair. For hair, I'm going to start from here and all the way over here. It's like a grass style, or you can say zigzag. So curvy. Over here, and here it will come back kind of V upside down, and then it will go over here, and this one almost same or little bit low. Next step, next to this one, I made a point over here, so I will go here just like curvy. I'm doing curvy up and then go down. So you can say alphabet N over here, and almost same height over here, so it will go like this or get a little bit curvy. So I already did this part, but it's not showing, so I'm going to do the little bit dark dotted line. I always do that. So I always make dotted line. If I like it, then I trace it. Otherwise, I erase and fix, and it's very easy for me. So the way you really like it, like if you really want to draw directly and you will get it, you can draw directly. But I really like to draw light and then go for the darker line. Let's draw the curvy line for the head. And then I'm going to draw the hill style. Up, down, up, and then connect from the other side of the head. Done. Now I'm going to do the same thing one more time. Top part, again it will be just like a hill. Up, down, up. And it gap is going to be pencil gap, you can say. And then connect with the other side of the head. The top part of the body, or you can say the back, it's almost like a 2 centimeter. It can be a little bit big or small, doesn't matter that much. And then you have to connect. It's kind of like, you can say, kind of like what? Interesting U shape, you can say, but I didn't connect in the middle because that's going to be fin. Fin, when you are drawing, you can wiggle a lot or you can wiggle a little bit. It just depends, means the way you really like. Time I mark over there and then I connect, so it's very easy for me to do curve between two marks. This is the another fin. You can wiggle little bit this one and then make more wiggly type of fin. And this is the tail part, kind of like a smiley or you can say, but the bottom part, the back one, it's a little bit wider. This part is a little bit wider than the connecting part. The top part, you can notice that's more curvy than the bottom one. Same thing I'm going to do with this fin. The top is going to be more curvy. The bottom line is going to be a little bit straight. And side is going to be more curvy, means wiggly, curvy. This is curvy, more curvy. This is more straight. And this is wiggly. This one is going to be a little bit smaller than that one. I made 2 marks, so it will be easy, and then I'm going to do wiggle over here. Now it's time to draw the scarf. For scarf, you can do thicker one, thinner one, bigger one, smaller one, 3 lines, 5 lines, 2 lines, 7 lines. It's totally up to you. It kind of like a snowman style, so you can pick anything for that. Now I wanted really dark, rich red color, so I did green color. All these things I'm going to write down on the description box. So if you have these markers, you will get exactly same color. So I did the green color on the top. I'm doing the red color, so I will get more dark red color. Now this area is going to be a little bit more darker, so I'm using green on the top of the red. Now we are ready for the new trick. For that one, you have to ask your mom, and she has to open her makeup box and give it to you. That's going to be the makeup tool and makeup powder. So that one you can use for the skin tone. Right now I'm using the makeup tool, like eyeshadow one. Now I'm using the brush, and it's really smooth, just like a butter, and it's very easy to color with this one. For the darker yellow, I'm using purple color over here, and wherever I do not need dark shade, I will directly use the yellow marker. So I'm using the yellow right now, and I'm doing on the top of purple, so it will blend and it will give me a little bit darker yellow shade. Now I'm using the silver metallic marker, and I'm just doing on the top of the black Sharpie marker. And I'm doing 2 times, so when it will dry, we can see the metallic shade over there. Now I'm going to use Mr. Sharpie to outline everything, and this time I'm not going to use on the top of the silver line. I will use next to the silver line and outer side. For hair, I'm using the green color, and I will cover the whole hair part with this green, and then I will use different color on the top of it, and at the same time I will highlight. With this darker green shade, I am trying to cover the whole thing But mostly on the left side, you will see I'm doing 2 or 3 times. So it will be more dark and it will be more highlighted. Now I'm drawing just small circle and I will color this one with the black color, and I made a tiny reflection one. I will leave it white. If you color that one, you can just paint that one with the white, or you can use white gel pen. You can make a dot over there. If you want to move the eye, you want this reflection on the left or right, you can do that. And this is the bluish shade I'm doing. But I'm doing like a beach ball style, you can say, or all the strokes, they are going towards the middle, or from middle it's going towards the outside. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like and subscribe to my channel.